good married according to the priest.
Yeah. She looks so beautiful.
But you know what?
What?
She doesn't look half as beautiful as you.
As best person.
And a fine best person you turned out to be.
Thank you very much. As best person, it is my responsibility to toast the happy couple. Yeah. And since I'm not very good at public speeches, I'm going to keep this really simple. Lois and Ned. The labor has been long and hard to get you two together, but looking at you two today, I can't even remember any of the pain. I love you very much. To the happy couple.
What's the matter?
Oh, I'm just checking for false bottoms, that's all.
Gotta know her deep inside, hear every thought, see every dream, and give her wings when she wants to fly. When you can see your unborn children in her eyes, you know you're really
you.
Well, I mean, not that I did it single-handedly or that they wouldn't have eventually ended up together on their own, but do you guys realize how many months I was the only person who knew that Eddie was really Ned and I never told anybody? And here they are, they're all in love, and all that plotting and patience finally paid off. They're so happy. And I'm happy.
As much as Ned gets under my skin, I have to admit, I think he'd do the same for you. Friends respect confidence of friends, right?
Right. You're right.
Yeah, actually, I'm just trying not to get sick.
Stone, do you want...
Take it easy. Just keep your head down for a couple minutes.
Okay. What's the matter?
Oh, no, I'm taking these pills for my leg. Just these painkillers is just not agreeing with my stomach. Mm.
Here, try this. This should help. Just take small steps, okay?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm okay. I'll be okay. I'll just be glad to get home. Lay in bed.
Yep.
All right. But I wouldn't miss going to see Lois get married. No matter how lousy I felt, how much my leg hurt right now.
Do you want me to call Dr. Quartermain?
No. Like, maybe I just need some air.
If you want to, yeah. Let's go out on the platform.
No, it's all right. I'll go with you.
Are you sure?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Go. For sure.
as if the boat getting grounded wasn't bad enough, there was this guy.
And he's a Carowitz, rock and roll son of the neighborhood butcher.
And Lois's old boyfriend.
He was there?
Powder blue tux, accordion.
Accordion?
Apparently, he assaulted the Cirillo home, and he made a move on Lois, so he came to apologize. So he broke into this incredible rendition of Lady of Spain.
Oh, skip the gruesome details. Did they get hitched or not?
Yes, they did, and it was so beautiful.
Well, good. I'd say I'm sorry I missed it, but I'm not. You see, me and weddings have a sort of historical antipathy. We don't go together very well.
What do you mean?
Yeah, well, that's a tale, a murky tale for another rainy day. Listen, as long as you're here, do you mind if I split? I need to take a quick look around the old hacienda before I turn in.
Any problems?
Well, no, but Lucky was in here earlier, and he's feeling a little squirrely about the security situation since I'm not over there. So I just thought I'd go by, you know, check the perimeter out, make sure everything's all right. And then I'll be at Jones's, you know, sleeping over there, if you need me.
All right, I'll hold down the fort and see you in the morning.
Ah, wiped.
I hate unpacking, but I know if I don't, everything's going to get all wrinkled.
Well, let it, because I'm going to unpack my toothbrush, and I'm hitting the rack.
Aren't you forgetting something?
What?
The big secret you've been keeping?
Tonight?
Yeah, well, you said you were going to tell me as soon as we got home, and we're home, so might as well get it out of the way.
Tell you what, why don't we get a good night's sleep and get into it first thing in the morning?
Why is this such a big deal?
I'm beat. Brenda, we both are.
Sonny, you know that I'm not going to be able to get any sleep. I'm going to be tossing and turning all night long, wondering what's going on.
I don't want to have another fight over this.
Neither do I. Look, I know whatever this secret is, it is tearing you up inside, which is making us both crazy. What you're doing right now is really unfair, you know, because you told me at the wedding that you were going to tell me what's going on right afterwards, and I trusted that. You know, I think I was really good about it, too. I let it go so we could have a good time, and we did. We had such a good time.
Yeah, we did, sweetie.
Don't you know the whole time all I could think about is that I know there's something really heavy going on with you, and I cannot believe that you want to leave me hanging again.
You're making this really hard, babe.
It doesn't have to be hard. I don't want to pressure you. If you just tell me what's going on, maybe I could help you. At least I could stop imagining all the horrible things it could possibly be.
You don't got AIDS. Is that horrible enough for you?
You're done.
I'm sorry, sir.
You know what? You're wrong. This is a mistake.
He's been checked and double-checked. The doctors already have him on AZT. You know how lousy he's been feeling.
You're telling me that Stone is HIV positive?
It's beyond that.
Oh, my God. What about Robin?
She was tested last week. She was negative so far.
What does that mean, negative so far?
When Stone first got tested, he was negative too. She's gonna have to have another test in 6 months and more after that.
I don't understand. Stone tested negative and now he has AIDS. I don't understand that. It doesn't make any sense.
When he first came off the street, I made him get tested. The way we figure is that he was infected already and it didn't show up. And He wasn't involved in what they call high-risk behavior. It never occurred to him to get tested again.